My name is Aaron Boes. We are at the Berenson-Allen Center for Non-Invasive Brain Stimulation, and that's housed at the Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center and Harvard University. My position, I'm a pediatric neurologist and a research fellow. So the goal of our lab, generally speaking, is to study non-invasive brain stimulation and to use that technology to understand how the brain works in the healthy conditions, and also how we can potentially use the technology to treat disorders of the brain. So I'm from Emmitsburg, Iowa, which is a small farming community in northwest Iowa, and did my training at the University of Iowa. My parents are not scientists, but they're in related fields. So my dad taught science at a community college, and my mom was a nurse. My interest in science really developed in college. I would say I had some interest in science courses going through grade school and high school, but never really thought of myself as somebody who would want to be a scientist. I think my vision at the time was probably somebody who had crazy white hair and a lab coat and was mixing together chemicals in a lab and things like that. And so I never really thought very seriously about a career in science until I did a summer job as a research assistant after my sophomore year of college. And that was very eye-opening. So we were asking a lot of exciting questions about how the brain works. People were really into it. The PI that I was working with was very passionate about his work. And it was a lot of fun. So I really never was asking the question, like, do I want to do science after that? It was, how can I keep doing this? I mean, what kind of training do I need? What kind of education? So we don't have one specific disorder that we study. There are a variety of interests in the lab. So we're studying autism, schizophrenia, depression, among others. There are probably about 40 people in the lab total. So that includes a variety of different PIs in the lab. Three or four of us would be considered PIs, research fellows, which would include myself. There are research assistants, there are rotating students. So all together, we're probably about 40. And then we break off onto different projects. So usually there are about four or five of us that would be working on a given project at any time. Some of the projects going on right now is how to better diagnose those conditions. So right now, things like autism, for example, are diagnosed just based on the behavior of the child. We're not really using neuroimaging or any sort of neurophysiology to make that kind of diagnosis. And we have some preliminary data to suggest that things like TMS might actually provide a biomarker for a disorder like autism. He's applying the stimulation here. We're basically measuring the motor activity in his hand right there, and that's projected on here. So when you give the pulse of stimulation, you see a little blip there, and then you can see the contraction of the muscle, so we know that we're hitting the right spot. So that would be one example. We're also looking at ways to improve how depression is treated. So using TMS, or transcranial magnetic stimulation, is a way to focally deliver pulses of electromagnetic energy right into the brain. And when you do that, you basically change the excitability of the brain. And if you do it for a prolonged period of time, 20, 30 minutes, and do it every day, you can actually cause long-term changes in the brain. So that already works for depression. We know it works, but it could work better. So we're trying to combine that technology with neuroimaging to see if we can optimize exactly where we stimulate to improve outcomes. I think on a broad level, in terms of how I see my career going, what I ultimately want to do is find a way to bridge everything that we're learning about cognitive neuroscience, which has been developing now for 20 or 30 years in terms of functional imaging and how we understand these complex processes going on in the brain and these various disorders of the brain, and sort of bridge that gap through non-invasive brain stimulation to see if we can correct some of these problems that we know have gone awry based on neuroimaging. So I think that's kind of the process that I see myself working on for the rest of my career. It's too interesting, I think, to ever get tired of it, and it's something that I still find very fascinating, and I'm still seeking out those books to try to better address this question. And honestly, probably in my lifetime, we'll never fully understand how the brain works, but I feel like we made a lot of progress since I started reading about it. It's even, this would have been about 15 years ago or something like that, and I'm sure we'll continue to make progress.